we're going to find out about a Muslim that was raised from the dead in the morgue. Guess what he believes about Jesus now? Hello, Sid Roth. Welcome to my world where it's naturally supernatural. I'm with a very interesting person. His ancestor was the best friend of Muhammad, and he was the first caliph of the entire Muslim world. Is that right, Nasser Siddiqui?
That is absolutely right,
Sid. That's quite a genealogy that you have.
Yes, that's why the name Siddiq is synonymous with Abu Bakr Siddiq, the first caliph of the Muslim nation.
So, out of curiosity, would most Muslims recognize your last name?
Absolutely, absolutely. If I was to go to the Middle East, they would immediately recognize Nasser Siddiq. He's family from the Siddiqs.
And speaking of family, he came from a very prosperous family, but he didn't do so bad himself. By 35, he was a millionaire. He had all the neatest cars and homes and everything Hollywood says they'll make you happy. But you know what? He developed a deadly disease. Tell me about that, Nasser.
I got very sick, and it started off with blisters on the side of my neck. And by the morning, it had grown to blisters half inch in size on the side of my
This isn't supposed to happen to you. Everything.
No.
But of course, you were working about 18 hours a day. So your immune system was ripped.
Yes.
Down minus zero.
They rushed me to hospital. I had passed out twice that night. They rushed me to hospital, Toronto General Hospital in Toronto, Canada. In the emergency section, they diagnosed it as the worst case of shingles ever recorded in the history. I was in so
much. But wait a second, I had shingles and I was in pain, but that wasn't, I couldn't die from it.
Well, this one was from the top of my head all the way down here, all the way down the side of my face, this ear, this neck, this shoulder. They admitted me to hospital. The next morning, this ear was touching this shoulder. It was like a balloon. I looked like a leper, deformed on this side. And my immune system was not fighting back.
Now, you have a picture of that. Would
yes,
you show
yes,
us that?
Absolutely. This is what I look like in that hospital room. Mm. Blisters 1 inch in size, chickenpox, temperature 107.6, and brain damage. In this condition, with hypothermia, they left me to die.
Well, the doctors actually came into the hospital,
yes,
standing over your bed.
Yes.
They think you're out of it. You're sleeping.
Yes.
What did you hear them say?
They examined me and they said that his immune system has shut down. This is spreading across his body. We can't do anything about the hypothermia because the brain had cooked itself, and they said I would probably be dead by the morning. In fact, Anita, they took her out of the room afterwards and explained to her that, A, if I lived,
this is someone that worked with you.
Yes, my eye would be blind, my ear deaf, there's brain damage, this side of the face would be paralyzed, and if I lived, I would be a vegetable, but probably I would be dead by the morning.
Okay, you hear this horrible report.
Yes.
You're a Muslim.
Yes.
Did you prepare? What does a Muslim think when he gets a death sentence?
Allah is not a healer. Muhammad is not a healer. So we don't turn to Allah to heal us. We assume that we're going to die. But I was afraid of death, Sid. I was petrified of
death. Why?
I didn't know what was on the other side, but
right,
I was afraid of it. And the very people that I had my faith in, my trust in, were those doctors. And they had just given up. What do you do when the people you got your trust in have given up on you and left you to die? In fear, I cried out. I said, God, if you're real, don't let me die. That's what I cried out. Muhammad didn't come, Allah didn't come, but that night, in that room, there appeared a figure at the end of the bed. And this person...
Wait a second. Had you ever seen something supernatural like this before in your entire life?
Never.
This is your first time?
Yes.
Okay. Now there's this figure.
Yes.
And are you scared? What's going on?
No,
with it?
No, not at all.
Okay.
I wasn't scared at all. In the middle of the night, I see this figure at the end of the bed, and it was the outline of a person with light radiating from them.
Hmm.
I couldn't tell you the way the face looked, but all I could see was this outline of a person with light. Now, I knew it was Jesus. these people come to me and they say, but you're a Muslim. Muslims don't know Jesus. Oh, yes, they do. If you read the Quran, Jesus is mentioned many times as a good man, as a healer, as a prophet. Even his birth is mentioned and that he healed people.
But the main thing I understand about Islam, they say God has no son.
That's
look at the mosque when they have it right on top in Jerusalem.
That's right. He has no son. Well, this person that appeared said two things. I am the God of the Christians, and I'm the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Wait a second. As a Muslim, isn't it Abraham, Ishmael, and Jacob?
Right. That's right. Ishmael was supposed to be the firstborn,
right?
Not Isaac, but that's not what this person said. Abraham, Isaac. So to me, it meant a whole lot. But even more astounding was that the next morning, the same doctors walked in and they said, we don't understand what's happened. It is a miracle. It has gone into remission. Instead of spreading, they are starting to decrease.
Now, when they said that to you, what did you think?
I said, look, I don't know what to tell you, but there was a
person. Did you tell
them?
You told them? Oh, they're going to put you in a mental ward.
I told them, there was Jesus here, and he healed me. And
a Muslim saying that, they're going to put him away.
They didn't believe me. And that became a test case in the city of Toronto. Why is this man alive? In fact, they said it's gone into remission so much, you can go home now. And I said, no, I don't want to go home. That was my security. That little room was my security.
You wanted that man to come back?
Yes, absolutely. They released me the next day. Now, the problem was that even though it had gone into remission, my head still looked deformed.
Right.
And so when I would walk down the street, people would cross over the other side. They didn't know what was wrong with me.
But what did you do with this man saying, I am the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob?
Well,
Isaac!
I know.
Yes,
it's like, wait a minute. This doesn't make any sense. Is this Jesus that appeared in my room, is he a prophet, the way the Muslims had taught me all my life? Or is he the Son of God?
Hold that thought. Let's find out how God supernaturally shows Nassar that he's the Son of God. Jesus is the Son of God. It's the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Don't go away. This is amazing.
We'll be right back to It's Supernatural.
Hello, Sid Roth here with Nassar Siddiqui. And Nassar is a Muslim. He is literally dying, the worst case of shingles the hospital had ever seen. And a man comes in, he just intuitively knows that it's Jesus, and he's emanating such love, such light, that healing begins to start in Nassar's body. The doctors don't understand it. They release him. He wasn't completely healed, but he went from no hope to being able to leave the hospital. But he had a problem because this man that visited him, Jesus, said, I am the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And if he knew one thing, he knew God has no son, but that's what he said.
Exactly.
So what did
said.
You do about that?
I had that burning question. Is Jesus really the Son of God? And I got home that day, the day I was released from the hospital. The next morning, I wake up at 6 o'clock. I don't know why I woke up at 6, turned on the television. There were two men, just like here, talking about that very question. And on the screen, it says, is Jesus the Son of God?
My goodness.
Coincidence? I don't think so. That was the very question that was in my heart. And they're talking back and forth. And they were talking about how God sent his Son to die on the cross for our sins, because of his love for us.
What did this mean to you? It's so strange.
Well, as a Muslim, I was taught all my life that to know that you're going to heaven, your good works have to exceed your bad works. And it's only through works. The only exception of that in Islam is called jihad. Jihad is when you die for your cause. You die for your God. And here I'm hearing these two men talk about not dying for your God, but your God dying for you. I'd never experienced that kind of love in my life. And I said, could this be true? Could it be true that God, the Father, sent Jesus, the Son, to pay the price for my sins, for everything that I've done wrong? This was all new to me, but it was exciting. And these men were talking back and forth that, yes, Jesus is the Son of God. And, yes, it is documented that he walked the earth. And it is documented that he healed. And it is documented that he died on the cross and paid the price for the sins of all men.
So what happened with this horrific disease that you had?
Well, that day when that program finished, I got on my knees. They led me in a prayer. I asked Jesus to be the Lord of my life. I found a photograph of the way I used to look, and I started praying to this Jesus. Can you make me look like this again? I had looked 75 years old. I had my whole face was aged. 5 days later, I woke up at 5 o'clock in the morning. The doctor said, don't scratch the blisters, they're contagious. But I saw some on my pillow, so I must have scratched them in the middle of the night. I got out of bed, stood under the shower, said for an hour and a half, every single blister from the top of my head, my face, my ear, my neck, my shoulder, fell. And the skin was red like raw meat. And the doctor said I would have white blotches. But as you can see,
no.
There's no blotches.
So is there any doubt in your mind that God is the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and that Jesus is his son? Any doubt?
No doubt.
I'll tell you.
I have living proof.
I'm sure of that. So Nasser ends up, storybook, he marries his associate, Anita. They go on a month wedding. They've got all of this money, and then there's a downturn in the economy. They go all the way down. They're out of money. And then his wife is expecting, and she develops a life-threatening disease. And Nasser thinks she's going to die. However, he's been reading the Bible all of this time, and he gets all sorts of tapes on healing, and he plays them 24/7 for Anita. What happened to her briefly?
She collapsed outside of a mall. Then she had 6 catatonic seizures a day. They took her to St. Michael's Hospital, put 28 needles in her head, diagnosed multiple sclerosis, said that she would be a cripple, gave me a catheter and a wheelchair, said, you take her home. There's nothing we can do. There's no cure. She's going to lose the rest of her organs. I knew one scripture really well. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. When the world is given up, you better turn to Jesus. And so I got as many tapes as I could on healing scriptures, scriptures that teach on healing, and I played them by her bedside 24 hours a day. Before I did that, Sid, I took all my friends, all my relatives, all my neighbors that didn't believe like me, kicked them out of the house. She did not need sympathy. She did not need chocolates. She did not need flowers. She needed the Word of God 24/7. For 2 straight years.
And you're getting it too.
Yes, both of us listening to the Word 24/7. The Word is getting in, because faith doesn't come by any other way but by hearing. So she heard the Word, heard the Word, heard the Word, built up her faith that, wait a minute, 2,000 years ago, Jesus carried every sickness and every disease, including multiple sclerosis. And if he carried it, why is she carrying it now? She had to get that revelation. And when that word exploded on the inside of her, now we started to see her getting better and better.
Did it explode in you too?
Absolutely.
You knew for sure she'd be healed?
I knew for sure that if anything could heal her, it would be the Word of God.
Okay, so she gets healed, and Nasser comes back, and everything is doing wonderful again. And the disease tries to come back. Don't go away. What happens when a disease that's going to kill you, you're healed, and you're excited, and you rejoice, and everyone is happy, and everything is coming back, everything is wonderful, and then the disease, what was the name of the disease?
Multiple sclerosis for Anita and shingles for me.
They both came back?
They both came
back. On you? Let's find out. Don't go away. We'll be right back, too.
We'll be right back to It's Supernatural!